What is up YouTube, this is Lifehacks again. So in this tutorial, I'll be showing you what you need to do after installing Ubuntu 15.10. So before we begin to this tutorial, I want to say something, okay? So every command I have used in this tutorial, it will be in the link in description, so you guys can have a fun and just copy and paste, so you guys will have no problem at all. So now let's get begin. So just click on the dashboard right over here, search your computer. Now you gotta be typing source like that, okay? Just type a source and go to the software and updates. Now you gotta be choosing or just have a tick mark on these all, and then also use the download from your config server. So I'm on Nepal, so I'm using the Nepal server. If you guys are in something country, then also you guys can use from here. There are a bunch of country, or also you can use the selected base server. This will make your Ubuntu have a good server, and you can download faster than moreover using the main server. So make sure to use the best server, so you will get a best down speed for whenever you use the software center or any sources software. So next is you gotta be going to the additional drivers, and guys you need to install right over from here and get apply changes. So in my case, I have the Intel CPU, so I'm using right now an Intel CPU micro mode firmware. So also you guys, if you guys are using the laptops or something, a wireless kit, then you will have a something called a wireless card driver, like your Broadcom or the Atheros, also even the Rallying, I think so. So you guys can just install it from the additional driver right over here. Also you guys can have install the GPU like the Nvidia and AMD Radeons. So have a fun with that, and just apply change it, okay? Just choose. I don't mean to choose you guys, and do not apply this device, okay? Just choose the using. So once you get with choosing all these and just crap off, close it out. Now you gotta be opening your terminal, so just type it here as a terminal, and then so we'll be using the first command to update our system. So use the sudo apt-get update, and also guys, make sure to check in my link in description, because I have given these all commands in the description box, so you guys can have a fun easy copy pasting. And upgrade, because we gotta be upgrading too. So just type is, if you guys want to type, then you can do that too. So just put this command and enter your password, and it will automatically update and upgrade your repository inside your source.list. So once you done that, then we will be moving on to the Ubuntu Software Center. So and I'll be showing you what you need to install in from here, because okay, so let's fully maximize this. So first thing, if you guys have seen that if you play the mp3 file or mp4 file whenever for the first time, you guys can't play it because you don't have any codec to run your media or multimedia files. So to run these files, you need to have the ubuntu-restricted-extras. So just type in ubuntu-restricted like that, restricted-extras. So if you guys also want to install this from command line, I'll be using and I'll be keeping the command in the linking description, so you guys can have a fun with it, okay? So just have a install. Just click on more info and install over from here. I have now you guys can already see I have already installed it, so now I can just remove it. So and the next thing is you guys gotta be installing the Compiz, okay? Compiz, you gotta be installing this one, okay? It's a Compiz, just go over here and install it. Compiz, it's a very fun to use. Once you use the Compiz, you will be customizing your Ubuntu very effectively. Also, it may crashes your desktop interface, because if you guys have any old computer, then I recommend it not to use the Compiz. For old desktop, I recommend you guys to use the Unity Twig tool, which is over here. So it's called Unity Twig tool. It's on here. Okay, just install this to have something effect like I have right now. As you guys can see, I'm opening and having the very nice fancy minimize and maximize, and there is many more. Okay guys, many more effect using these tools. These are very fantastic tool. If you guys ever don't use, then I recommend you to use the Unity Twig tool too for your Unity environment. So and the next thing is you gotta be installing this menu. It's called the classic classic menu indicator. So just type it here, classic. Okay, just type in classic and you will be popping up right over here. It's called the classic menu indicator. Just install it, and once you install, then I recommend you to reboot your computer, because if you gonna open it right now, then you guys can see these all the accessories, games, graphics, internet and other alls. Okay, so once you install the classic menu indicator, make sure to restart your computer and come back. And the next is we gotta be installing something called Gdebi. It's the guys, it's called the dev package manager. You guys can directly install dev package manager. Now I want to give you some example on a dev package manager. As you guys can check it here, there is the .dev extension right over my computer. So to install this, you have a three choice. One is from the Ubuntu Software Center, and next is from the Gdebi package manager, and from last one is from the terminal, where you can just open the terminal and type in code, some kind of code, and install the Google Chrome right over from the terminal. So you can do it from three ways using. So the easy way is to download the Gdebi package manager. It will also save your time more than using the Ubuntu software center or the terminal. So just open it and click it over here and just install the package. I have already installed this, so I don't need to do. So I'm just quitting it all. Okay, it's gonna be not responding for my computer. Sorry for that. So and the next is the Synaptic Manager. Oops. Okay. So also install this guy's Synaptic Package Manager. It's a very you guys, it's very cool. Okay, you guys should be installing this Synaptic Package Manager. It's very awesome. To open it, you need your root access. Okay, so I recommend you to use the Synaptic Manager from the terminal, or also you guys can use from the dashboard if you want. Just type in sudo and synaptic and give him a password, and it will open you like that. This is basically like the Ubuntu Software Center. You can install anything which you want. So also you guys can have a category right over here, and also you guys can install anything. I have already told you, games, softwares, and everything what you need to. Okay, if you want the all, then just click on all and source the package. And also you guys can just download the package and install it later on if you want. Also you can delete something, okay, from here if you don't want it. So this is a Synaptic Package Manager. It is very popular, all are using. If you guys have a laggy software center, then I recommend you to use the Synaptic Package Manager. And okay, so next is the, I want to show you here something, as you guys can see or not, but this is the annoying text right now. This is the my country language. So to remove the To remove it and change the English, you just need to go to dashboard and type in the language like that, and go to language support, and it will checking available language support. And we gotta be skipping that. Okay, so you gotta be clicking in the remind me later. So go to the regional format and choose the English United States. Make sure to choose the English United States, and it will take some time. Okay, and then apply system wide, so it will upload. Okay, ask me your password right now, and then close it out. Now just restart your computer, then you will see here AM or PM right over here, or it will change all these this crap kind of the word. I don't want this my language, because I use the English word, so I don't like it. If you guys like it, then I recommend not to change for YouTube. And the next thing is that we gotta be also checking on the security and privacy. Okay, so just type in dashboard like a security and privacy, and open the security privacy. So this is all upon for you guys. If you want to say, okay, let's see, just uncheck these all, okay, because it's kind of use your system as hunger, and to, and your memory is gonna and your memory is gonna eating a lot of stuff, okay, and it may also crash sometime. So just turn it off, and also turn it off the web source and online results, and also uncheck these all. If you guys want to help the Canonical partners, then I recommend you to check these. But if you don't want, then I recommend you not to check. So that's all about the security privacy concern. And the next, if you guys want to install the Java, then you guys can also install from the software center, or also you guys can install from the command line. It's called the OpenJDK. Okay, it's not coming up right now. Alright. And guys, right now, I don't know why it's not showing. Let's close it out. So, I'll be putting the link in the description so you guys can install the Java. It's called the OpenJDK. Please check the link in the description down below. So, I want to say, okay, also, I want to check the next command. We are going to do is we are going to check our swap memory right now. So to check the swap, just go to a dashboard, and also you guys can check your swap using system monitor. As you guys can check it here, over my swap is the 4.2 gigabyte. So it's not using right now. So if you whenever use the heavy program like open shots or games like the open arena and assault cube and cube 2, then it will be eating more, and your system gotta be going on hunger. So just close it off, and we gotta be and guys so we gotta be typing how much the swap it's gonna be it's eating right now. To check it, you just need to type in cat and slash proc and slash sys and virtual memory for the VM slash swappiness, and just press an enter, and it will show you the default value. It's always a default as 60. So to we gotta be changing it. So to change it, we gotta be using the super use command. Just type in sudo z88. Worry not guys, all the commands are in the link in the description, you can check it off. Just type in sysctl and con. And it will, okay, sorry guys, because I have intruder run command right now. It's something called sudo z-edit edit c and sys I think this was a problem right now. Okay, so just press enter. Okay, so we gotta be you guys gotta be looking something like this. Now what you need to do is go on the bottom part right like that and just press it enter, and then we guys we gotta be typing a comment to something like say that decreasing swappiness. So swap, okay. So now you gotta just be typing vm.swap swappiness, okay, and is equal to 10. So once you do that, then just save the save your file and close it out, and then restart your computer and come back and check using this command. It will show you a 10. So right now mine is 60. So if I restart right now, it will show me the 10 as swappiness value. So okay, guys, that's all. Also, I want to show you something cool. Next step, it's called the Ubuntu Twig. You guys can just easily download it. Just go to google.com or Google, open a Google Chrome or Firefox, and just type it all. Ubuntu Twig, and just go to the first link. This is the link we are be visiting, and just download it. Okay, I have already downloaded, so I don't need to download it. So from the download folder right over here, as you guys can see, it's a .dev file. Just right click, you can have a three choice installation. I have already told you, a command line and a software center and a Gdebi package manager. So install using the easy way, use the Gdebi, and go and open your Ubuntu Twig after installing. And let me open it. Okay, guys, I think so. My screen recorder is going crazy right now, so it's not opening. So sorry for that, guys. I'm very sorry for because I can't show you the Ubuntu Twig. From here, just start the janitor because you guys can use Ubuntu Twig as the cats cleaner. And also you guys can have installing various software installations, so you guys can have fun with the Ubuntu Twig. So just spend the time on Ubuntu Twig, okay? So that's all about the video. So if you guys have any problem or any question regarding to this video, then please comment down below. I'll be replying guys soon as possible. So make sure to watch my next later videos for the furthermore, and keep in touch with the Life Hacks channel. So peace out and bye bye.